I pray for Sister Gemma right now. I bless the sister right now, Father, spiritually and physically. Give more blessing, Father. In the name of Jesus, you are the God of blessing. You bless all the spiritual blessing in Christ Jesus. I bless sister. Give more hope in the future life. And also I pray for you to declare the healthy body, sister. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
And the pastor,
okay.
God bless you.
Give it up. Okay.
Amen.
So today, this is a commandment. This is a commandment of the Lord. Praise the Lord. What is the commandment? Pray for the sick. Declare the healing. Not in my name, but in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. God bless you. Lord. This is the commandment of the Lord today. I am preaching the gospel. So today, all the people are walking here. Bible says, today is a day of your salvation. Not tomorrow. Not today to tomorrow. In the Bible, lots of people, they were living in this world. When Jesus Christ was preaching the gospel in Samaria, in Jerusalem, in Judea, what happened? Wherever the people, they were hearing this word of God. In that all the places, people, they were standing the surrounding place of Jesus Christ. For what purpose? What is the reason? Only for one purpose, to receive the healing. Only for one purpose, to receive the eternal life. Only for one purpose, they want to come out from their sinful life to the glorious life of God. Today, the people are in the Derbyshire city center, in the North UK. This is a message. Today, I want to share to each one of you. In Jesus Christ, there is a forgiveness of your sin. In Jesus Christ, Bible says, by the blood of Jesus Christ, there is a sanctification. Jesus Christ is sanctified and redeemed by his blood in your life. In your life, there is a redemption. Jesus Christ has redeemed you by his blood. Today, how you can experience the presence of the Lord? God,
right? I'm
preaching gospel. What? I'm preaching powerful gospel that Jesus Christ is alive. You are not. Right? God bless you. So today, am I right? Jesus Christ is alive. So the people are walking here. If you want right, you're most welcome. If not, no problem. So, this is what in the early centuries. All the disciples, they were preaching about the powerful gospel to everyone. All the people, they were hearing this word of God. They were receiving the healing. They could able to come out from their sinful life to the glorious life of Jesus Christ. That is what the Bible says. Even if you are a sinful person, Bible says you can come to the holy life. How it is possible? By Jesus Christ. In Jesus Christ. And through Jesus Christ. Bible says those who are in Christ Jesus, there is no condemnation for you. Bible says if you are believing Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior, Bible says you are the holy person. There is no condemnation. Those who are in Christ Jesus, I'm really enjoying what I'm preaching. Now there is a court.
Yes.
And your body is hot right now.
Yeah, yeah.
Praise the Lord. When I start to preach the gospel, too much freezing. Now there is no freezing. Is a hot, I can remove my jacket right now. No problem. So today, either some people joke, some people will never hear this word of God. But this is the truth. Your life is very short. Praise the Lord. Maybe one more coronavirus, you will be out from here. This is up to God. I'm not the person to say like that. But if you're lucky, you'll be here. If not, you'll be out from this world. But only one person, one thing. I want to share to each one of you. Now, when you're living in this world, now you are going to get the eternal life and the heavenly life by Jesus Christ. If you are having faith in God, if Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior, even if you are getting die from this world, you are not at all getting die in your spirit. You are getting a life everlasting with the Jesus Christ. So today, all the ladies and gentlemen, come out from your blindness today to the glorious life of Jesus Christ. I want to encourage you, all the people, please come out from your sinful life and receive this powerful gospel in your heart. When the day, when the time, when the moment, when we receive this powerful gospel in you, Bible says, Jesus Christ said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Doesn't matter your situation. Doesn't matter your circumstances. Doesn't matter which country you are from. But only one thing. What was it? As well as received. If any of the people, the person, those who are believing and accepting that Jesus Christ is his Lord and Savior, doesn't matter where, which country you are from, doesn't matter which place you are from, doesn't matter maybe you are homeless or you have the home, doesn't matter. Our God is looking at you in the same eyes to everybody, each and every people, those who are in Christ Jesus. He can get you eternal life. Because Bible says, today is a day of your salvation. Not tomorrow. Not today to tomorrow. Not after a week. Not after a month. Today. This is the day which our God has created for you. Bible says, those who are in Christ Jesus, the goodness and mercy, it will follow you. Another nature of Jesus Christ. He is a loving God. One more nature of Jesus Christ I would like to say. He is a merciful God. If any of the people are believing in him and accepting Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior, Bible says his compassion, it will come to you. God's compassion, it will come to you. In the Bible, Gospel of John, chapter 6, we can see the compassion of the Lord. What is the compassion of the Lord? The compassion of the Lord, that means if the people, when the day, when the time, when the moment, when they are believing that Jesus Christ, this is a duty of the Lord to take care of their life. This is a duty of the Lord to get you the protection. Bible says, the goodness and mercy means, the goodness and mercy means, what all the needs you want in your life here today, our God is able to provide you in your life, whatever, maybe it doesn't matter, what all the situation which you're facing. The nature of Jesus Christ. If anyone is hearing this word of God, our God will take care of their life. This is what Gospel John chapter 6. Bible says, around 5,000 men, they were hearing this word of God. 5,000 men never hear this word of God. Last 3 days, they were with Jesus. Then what happened? When the time, when the day, when Jesus Christ finished, when Jesus Christ finished his preaching from the mountainside, all the people, around 5,000 people, they were feeling hungry. Bible says, the compassion of the Lord, it was moving to them that time, moved to them. Then Jesus Christ was asked to the Philip, I want to give, I cannot able to send these people from here to their home, because they all are hungry. Because they all are hungry. What happened? From the 5 loaves and 2 fish, Jesus Christ fed 5,000 men, around 25,000 people at the same time. Today, I want to preach the God which I am believing, the God of miracle, the God of powerful love, the God of mighty love, the God of living God. So today, according to the Bible, you cannot be faith in the entire areas of your life. Our God wants to touch you here today. Again, Bible says, the nature of Jesus Christ is a healing. The nature of Jesus Christ is a healing. If you are suffering any of the sickness here today, maybe you, your family members, your brothers, and your sisters, and any of the people are suffering any of the sickness here today, this is the right time to come and for the prayer. If you need the prayer, definitely we will pray for you. Jesus Christ will heal. Healing is the nature of our Lord. In the Bible, again Bible says, any of the people are having the hope in their heart to receive the healing. Our God will look at their heart. Our God will go personally to their home and our God will heal them. In the Bible, Gospel John chapter 5, there was a person who was a powerless person, who was having infirmity last 38 years. Gospel John chapter 5. What happened? He was having the hope in his heart, one day I will receive the healing from the God. Each and every day, so many years, he was believing and waiting to get the touch in his heart. But one day, Jesus Christ went to the pool of Bethesda. Jesus Christ was asking, God bless you, Jesus Christ was asking to the person, what I want to do to you. What do you need right now? What you are supposed to get from me? Why you are here? The person was saying to Jesus Christ, when the time of moving the water, nobody is helping me to get in the water. Jesus Christ has seen his heart. So Jesus Christ said, get up and rise up and walk. The same time, the person received the healing. Today, the people are walking here. Let me share Hanuk City Center. This is the good news. Never mind, never look at your situation. If you are having faith in God, this God can be able to heal your sickness. can get you the deliverance. This God can get you eternal life. This God can heal you and your sickness. This God can make you great in the patient. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you for the good comments. Praise the Lord. At least I want to say to each one of you, Jesus Christ is ready to do the healing in your body here today. But Bible says, are you ready to have it? If you are ready, come out today. I can pray for you. Healing will be yours. Deliverance will be yours. Eternal life will be yours. In short, the death cannot overcome your life. If you are the children of God, death is not the end of our life. Death is the beginning of our life with Jesus Christ forever and ever. Praise the Lord. So, all the brothers and sisters, in Christ Jesus, come out here today and bring this gospel. Accept this Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior. May your God bless you more and more. In Jesus Christ. Amen. In Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, is my God and Savior. Today onwards, I'm surrendering my life to Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Amen. Heavenly Father, bless this brother right now. In Jesus' name. Thank you for your blessing, this brother. This brother is your child right now. Spiritually and physically, I bless your brother right now, Father. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. You are a child of God, okay? God bless you. You bless me. Thank you. Thank you very much, okay? People want to get saved.
Yes.
Come back again. You want to pray one more? Anybody want to pray? Please come. I can pray for you. Not for joking. Anybody need the prayer? If anybody need the salvation, I can pray for you. You are going to receive the salvation within a second. Anybody want? I want to pray for the city right now. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for each one of them, especially the people are walking here, people are hearing this word of God. I bless them, Father. Keep them in your power. That brother, John, he accepted, he served. Heavenly Father, this is the reason I came from Portsmouth too. Let me share here today, even the night time, we are preaching the gospel only for him. He is your child. We declare this brother as the greatest evangelist in this nation, not only for UK, but in all of the nations. And also pray for all the people, those are walking here. Thank you for your blessing, dear Father. Keep them in your glory. And also pray, thank you for your giving the greatest revival from the city center. Thank you for your giving the greatest revival, a cloister from the city center, where I'm standing right now. Thank you for your making me to stand in front of them right now, Father. I bless each one of them. In Jesus' name, I pray. You understand? Amen. God bless you.